Hello and welcome back to the channel. As was mentioned in a previous video, probably about 4 weeks ago, I was going to have a go at doing a video build. The kit I chose to do the video build, or the kit I said I'd be doing the video build on, was this one. Wanted something that was fairly, fingers crossed, looked fairly easy to put together. So for my first attempt, this is what I'm going to do, and this will be part one. I don't know if there'll be any other parts concerning building. It might just get put together in part one, because there's, quite frankly, there's not that many parts. It depends what needs doing to them and how well they go together or anything like that. I've done no prep work or anything like that, so I will be, when we move over to the bench, the pieces will be out on the bench, and that's as far as I've got. I haven't looked at them, examined them or anything, so I don't know how long the series will be. It will probably be one build, two paint. Anyway, we'll go from there. I intend to do it in the style of so mainly it will be fast forward viewing. The building will go together quite fast where I'll accelerate the video, and then if I have anything to add, say, or interject into the build, I will obviously stop, and you know the sort of video that I'm on about. Hopefully we'll go from there. So without further ado, let's go over to the bench stroke table. So then, here we are on the video build of the Star Trek USS Enterprise. This is a lovely tin, gotta say. Embossed. One of the most impressive boxes that the kits come in. So, as I say, it's a small kit, so it shouldn't take much putting together. A lot of decals though. We'll leave them in the bottom for now. Let's see what we've got. It's an assembly sheet. An assembly sheet. So basically, upper dome, lower dome, fuselage halves together, lower hull. Yeah, there's not a lot to it at all, so we begin with the upper and lower hull, so it needs a bit of tidying up. This is knocking off. They're quite thick. I could easily, I think my Zeron plastic shears will cut straight through no trouble, but it may blunt the blades on them a bit if you keep doing that. So I don't want to snap them off, because look, if you start bending, see how it's starting to go white? There's stress marks in the plastic.
and it sort of leaves a horrible finish there, and it will probably need filling slightly if I do it that way. So time to get the knife out. So you want a good sharp knife. I've just replaced the blades on a lot of my knives, so I'll get them all out. There we go, I think I'll probably use this one. So, let's start by taking these off. Oh, they are quite yes, that's well, I'm not going to do it that way because so then we need to take the nubs off a little bit different than I normally do. I normally go like this and just chop them off. This is much too thick for that, so I don't cut myself, I'm going to have to go down onto it this way. This is very problematic. This is very, very thick. Had to get rid of the lugs on here in the end with a pair of soft cutting pliers. They're the only thing that was going to cut through something like that I had available to me. I didn't like doing it. It has left some damage. All I can do is sort of repair that when the time comes. And the webcam seems to be cleaning up something chronic. Keeps dropping off. I end up recording a load of stuff I've done, and then I turn around and realise the webcam's only recorded the first 2 minutes. So, all I can do is apologise, and if needs be, I'll have to make it more of a build update rather than a complete video build. But we'll see how we go. I'm going to give it another go and see if it will record. If you look carefully, you can probably see all the jumps already in the video where it's not sort of meshed up properly when I've edited it. But we'll try again. So, I can't remember where we got to on that video. We're cleaning this up. I'm cleaning this up, and then I noticed that the video had jumped again. Yeah, it's definitely going to need some filling. And if you can see there, if I put that on white, there, I don't know if that camera will, you can see that from that level, but there's a dink just there where it's took too much off. If we get there, let's see where it refills. There it is. So, there it is. Basically, that's happened in most of the spots. I'm not as bad as others. That's about the worst one. And I'm here. The damage is slight, but it's there. I don't know if you can see that. Put my looks like I've got really super powerful halogen bulbs in, but I haven't. Little lug there. Now, there's two different approaches I use when clearing something like this. The first would be to clamp it down, like so, just make sure we've got a fit, and then drop glue in and let the reaction seep round and do it that way. But the main problem with that, in allowing the glue to run around the seam on its own, is that when you come to get rid of the seam, the chances are you're probably going to get rid of a lot of the strength in the glue, because it's only going to bond on this outer edge. Tamiya thin cement is my personal choice for most things, but in putting it on there, by the time you get round to here, the chances are that that bit's already started drying, and you're not going to get a good bond that way either. So, I think on this occasion, what we need is cement. I was going to say good old fashioned cement, but it's not old fashioned, it is good though. My problem there is, so I've got cement, and yes, the webcam went off again. And the cement is actually clogged up in there, so I'm almost guaranteeing it. Just so that I can see if it is blocked, but I'm almost certain it is. Oh no, it isn't. Obviously got the cap on in time. So, right, hold on a second. Yeah. Okay. Just want to make sure that there's nothing got to go inside here before I attach this. No, so this is the lower man fuselage. That's the upper. Right. Now then, so it's probably going to be easier to run this around the rim. And what I do is put a bit extra where the guides are, where it guides in. Bit extra there, and then we'll also add Tamiya thin cement and it's clamped down just to get the seal on top. Right, so there we go. Let's get the cap on that. The good stuff about this is you don't have to rush to get it on. It's a lot slower at drying. That's the downside. These have to line up now. Just make sure we get the edges all twist, and then able to get a good grip on it. Damn. I didn't see the seating lug until it was due, so I'm going to have to just quickly twist again. You go in there with that, and you come round like this. Sit like that. Excellent. I'll do a little bit of work to clean up that seam line, but I think we're all level on there. That's taken quite well actually, so now just putting some clamps on. I've also got these clamps which have got rubber grips on there, and they're also angled.
So because of all the problems I've had with the webcam, I've changed the field of view and I'm using the webcam that is on the laptop. Field of view, point of view, sorry. hopefully we'll be able to carry on uninterrupted. Got that on. I'm coming to the end of a bottle of this. I don't like to waste stuff, so give it a shake. This will also help to hide the seam line, as it will melt the plastic together at the where the join is. I don't think I've got an old paintbrush. An old paintbrush, I could save no end of time on this. I don't want to sacrifice any of them. I think that's my dry brush for my dry brushing. Let's try that. Let's use that. Got a few windows etched in there that I don't really want to lose, but I can get them back. There we go, I'm just going to dip that straight in just to try and save the brush if I can. Ooh, it's a good job it's not smell-o-vision TV. Everyone to be high. Right, let's drop this to one side. Let's have a look at some of these parts. So what we got here, the two fuselage halves. Oh, they're going to come away quite easily. They probably don't even need cutting, they'll probably drop off if I wiggle it. There you go, I didn't even have to close the jaws together on that one. Unfortunately the plastic has got that white mark along where it's joined. That's the stress mark where the plastic started fracturing. Yeah, it's very unsightly, but it's all you can really do. I mean, at this stage, it's already too late. It's already there. The best thing you can do when separating them, really, is to cut a little bit further back and then try and be more precise with your knife when removing the ends. This plastic is different to the plastic I normally use, though. With other models, the plastic tends to have a softer feel to it. It's sort of easier to cut. This is very, very brittle. and I hasten to add, it doesn't so much cut as crack. So you've got to be very careful with it. These is that's the two halves there. That and that's going to go on like so. Excellent. And then the base will go on like this. And that's not a problem. So most of the time spent on this build is going to be with the cleanup phase. And then the painting, obviously, and decaling is going to be the big job. The building itself is very, very simple. Even so, I don't think I'm going to get this done all in one sitting. Purely because I have health issues, back problems for sitting for any period of time. I'm unable to sit for any period of time. I have a fractured coccyx, which is extremely painful, as anyone will tell you that's had any coccyx problems. It's excruciatingly painful. It's not playing up at the moment, but it doesn't take long to set off. So we've got a little lug there. You're going to come off. This plastic is so tough. Give that a trim off. Because of the angle I've got the camera at, apologies for... I have to have a look at the timer on the bottom of the screen, and because in essence the laptop is sort of like that, open like that, so that I can get the angle on the camera to look down on the table. So I have to come down and peep in. Hello. To check that we're still recording. Right, so again, I think I'm gonna use this again. Just press them two halves together. This go on. I just want to check because I don't want to glue a side that then doesn't, that requires the glue elsewhere. Sometimes you'll glue a surface and then find out that that isn't the actual surface that needs gluing. I'm not a fan of cement, to be honest. I find it messy. I only really use it when I absolutely have to. I love Tamiya thin cement and the thin items like that other companies do. There we go. Again, we're going to have to get rid of these seam lines, which may take longer than I first thought. It's definitely going to need some. I've got a sneaking suspicion that the fit is not going to be a very good one. Yeah, I'm going to need a bit of a longer clamp on that. Sorry, apologies for my ugly mug. There we go. Oh, after all that, I've got the one with the missing. Don't want too much tension on this at all. It's just to very gently push them two together. Just make sure we're okay down the side there. Work on getting this end in right first. Right, we're going to need a bit of I think we're going to need a bit of Tamiya thin to help close this end off a bit quicker than it's taken, just to act as a see if we can get cosy, maybe. I think they probably gonna need to put an elastic band around. Right, I think these are kits that I don't think it's going to quite go together as I envisaged in one session, because there's a lot that's a very poor fit. There's a lot of glue in. A lot of pieces going to need to be left to go off if I keep messing with it. If I keep messing with it, it's just going to deteriorate and not actually get any better. So this should give me good all-round pressure. Hopefully the rubber band will not glue to the fuselage. I'm concerned about this seam line. It runs straight down the middle. I know that I can get rid of the seam line, it's just that the detailing on the side are raised panel lines. And I don't know if that's going to be a problem, because obviously when I remove this seam I'm going to end up removing that then very faint panel lines. So I need to go away and do a bit of research on that, on what's going to be my best method of attack. Alternatively, if you've got any views, you can leave them in the comments section below. I think I'm going to leave the video there now. I may do a little bit more off camera, just a few little bits here and there before we come back and carry on. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. And we'll be back with part two of the Star Trek video build very soon. Thanks for watching.